Station, the Last Supper. On the night in which he was betrayed, took bread, and after he had given thanks, do this in remembrance of me. Do this whenever you drink it in remembrance of me.
Let us pray.
Lord
Jesus, you love us to the utmost. You love us to the end.
You remain
with us to be the continual sign of God's saving presence in all circumstances of life. Yourself to us in your loving presence in the Eucharist.
The second station, the agony in Gethsemane.
We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you.
Jesus went out and made his way, as was his custom, to the Mount of Olives. His disciples accompanied him. On reaching the place, he said to them, "Pray that you may not be put to the test." He withdrew from them about a stone's throw, then went down on his knees and prayed in these words, "Father, if it is your will, take this cup from me, yet not my will, but yours be done." In his anguish, he prayed with even greater intensity, and his sweat became like drops of blood falling to the ground. Then he rose from prayer and came to his disciples, only to find them asleep, exhausted with grief.
Let us pray. It was a long, terrible night, Lord, and at one of your disciples found the strength to keep your company in your agony. Your only strength was your determination to do the Father's will at all costs. Your solitary agony continues, even to this day, in the loneliness of those who have no friends, no home, no hope, no future. Our society is filled with them, but we prepare to know this number mercifully when they die victims in the grave.
Jesus went out and made his way, as was his custom, to the Mount of Olives. He said to them, "Pray that you may not be put to the other, if it is your will." And his sweat became like exhausted with grief.
It was a long, terrible night, Lord, as we were at all costs. Your solitary agony, society is filled with them, but we pretend not to know. Is now more noisily when they die victims.
Then Jesus answered, "I am, and you will see the Son of Man seated at the right robes," and said, "What further need do we have of witnesses?"
Lord Jesus, you are the judge of all human beings, yet you accepted from obstinate sinners. The unfair triangles of these injustices perpetrated against the weak, the defenseless.
The scourging and crowning with thorns.
We adore you.
Pilate asked the crowd, "What am I?" He said, "Why, scourge." Pilate delivered him his head and stuck a reed in his right hand. "Hail, King of the Jews."
Thus latent injustices.
The cross.
We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you.
the cloak, dressed him in his own.
The cloak was placed on the shoulders of the Son of God, the source of our holiness and goodness, to save us from eternal damnation. The cross he accepted to carry was our cross, the cross of our sins, our wickedness. To this very day, innocent men, women, and children are made to bear the cross of the grace, dear Lord, never to burden others with our moral defects. Let us pray. The distance from the Victorian to Calvary was not long. It was a few hundred meters. The death penalty that you alone bore, that we might.
Jesus is laid in the tomb.
We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you.
And had gone to request the body of Jesus. Thereupon the body, Joseph wrapped it in fresh linen and a frock. When he rolled this huge stone, the 14th station, Jesus rises from the dead.
We adore you, O Christ.
After the Sabbath, as the first day of the week, to inspect the tomb, sudden stone rolled it back and sat on it. Then the angel spoke, frightened, "I know you are looking for Jesus to promise. Go quickly and tell his disciples, he has."
Intention of our Holy Father, all together. Stay our daily bread and forgive us our trespasses. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is